In this video, we will talk about the use of StableLoc on the GPS 6500 and 7500 receivers and how to enable and disable it. Knowing when to use and when not to use StableLoc is important to make sure you are getting the best performance and accuracy on your operation. When StableLoc is enabled, and in the event the selected differential source is lost, StableLoc will smoothly transition to the next available lower differential source. Once the selected differential source is regained, StableLoc will smoothly transition back. To enable or disable StableLoc, begin on the home screen of the In Command display and tap the Setup app. Then tap the receiver and steering wheel icon to access the GPS and guidance setup page. Tap the wrench next to the receiver to enter the receiver setup page. In In Command version 3.5 and higher firmware, when using WAS and IGNOS as the differential source, StableLoc is enabled by default and cannot be turned off. Through testing, we've found increased performance has been observed when StableLoc is enabled. Tap the drop-down under differential source, then select TerraStar or RTK. For this example, we'll select RTK. When using TerraStar or RTK as the differential source, StableLoc is able to be enabled or disabled. Most operations using TerraStar will want StableLoc enabled. Operations where RTK accuracy is an absolute requirement, such as IntelliSlope, specialty crops, or operations where a topography map is being recorded, StableLoc will need to be disabled by tapping the checkbox. When enabled, tap the wrench next to the checkbox. This gives us the ability to enable WAS and EGNOS fallback. Tap the checkbox to enable this if you are inside a WAS coverage area. Areas outside of a WAS-EGNOS area will want this to be disabled, as the receiver can view WAS satellites but are unable to use them and will not converge rather than going directly to glide, causing unnecessary errors and downtime. The StableLoc error limit is the point at which the system will no longer allow auto-steer. If none is selected, the accuracy of the differential source will not affect the ability to auto-steer. Now, you will be able to identify when to and when not to use StableLoc on the GPS 6500 and 7500 receivers, as well as how to enable and disable this feature. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.